that even nations,
amen,
America,
amen,
shall bow before you.
Yes,
allow your mind to see that all Europe shall bow before you.
Amen.
When we say that you and I, we bow before Jesus,
yes,
that our system tolerate that.
Yes.
But our system is like allergic. Allergic. In terms of seeing nations bowing before him.
Yes.
But I'm telling you, even continents shall bow before him.
Yes.
Asia shall bow before him.
Yes.
Australia shall bow before him.
Yes.
Africa shall bow. That is not just here.
Yes.
Nations hearing. Nations are hearing.
Amen.
The devil in hell is here.
Oh, yes.
Don't make it like in a cell group Bible study. Volume. Make it as a volume that is speaking to the universe.
Yes.
You see, this altar is not the altar for a village. You understand?
Yes.
This altar is not the altar for your community here.
Come on, man.
Come on. This altar is the altar that will bring all nations under the knee before
you.
But therefore, give it some kind of volume in voice.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes.
So the grace that is released from here, the power, the anointing, the presence of God, is not the grace, the anointing, the power to get a little corner over there transformed, or two individuals transformed.
Yes, yes.
It's the grace and the power, the anointing,
yes,
and the fire to transform every nation. You don't know what kind of anointing you are sitting under. You understand?
Yes.
A man of God that was here, he came to me before flying out. He said, what I quote now is what I want you to release to me. Because this grace that you receive from God is not a usual grace. This is the man of God.
Yes.
This is a bishop. The grace that has been released to you is a grace that affects nations.
Amen.
Amen.
I was trying to affect my village and my community around.
Right, right.
Now God is making me a promotion to receive a grace and an anointing and the power to affect nations of the world. When you rob that thing, who told you you will not be able to deal with any problem anywhere, in any city, in any village, in any family? Who told you that?
Oh, that's good.
Do you understand?
Yes.
It's the magnitude. Yeah. It's called in French, now very good.
Yes.
It's the scope of the thing that you are not yet grasping. That's why you are joking with this. I'm not talking about, look at I myself.
Woo.
I should not joke with this.
Right.
If he has to remove me from worldwide synagogue revival, anointing.
Come on.
Yes.
Come on. Come on.
Synagogue here, anointing.
Come on, yes.
I'm not talking about the church. I'm saying synagogue. Anointing.
Hey,
you understand? And don't mean to leave the babyhood in the spirit. Then shifted now to establish network of national altars of prayer.
There you go.
For the Lordship of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Praise God.
Yes.
National, not a church altar. not personal altar, not a village altar, a national altar of the Lordship of Jesus, to take the nations, dedicate them to Jesus, so that His glorious presence from heaven, from the throne atmosphere, will descend in the nations, to transform the nations by His glory. If He move you to death, the man said, a fool that is in order, but who does not understand that order. A man that is in order, but doesn't understand it, is worse than a fool. You understand?
Yes.
Don't press with such thing.
Yes.
That's the grace of God.
Amen.
Nobody paid the price for it. It's Him who paid it.
Amen.
And graciously came and gave it to us.
Amen.
May the spirit man of the people in His church be open to receive what the Lord, as you say, what the hand of the Lord.
Yes.
No, I said nothing. I didn't see it. Amen. Are you getting ready for the word?
Yes.
Father, let your word come forth.
Amen.
Let your hand move mighty.
Yes.
Let the grace be released to affect the nation. Stir up the spirit of your people today.
Yes.
Thank you for so doing. Anoint your son, your servant.
Yes.
And let him be your mouthpiece.
Yes.
That your word will come freely and be glorified.
Yes.
Cover the whole thing with the blood of Jesus.
Thank you
that your angels have all over it. They have already taken position.
Thank you, Father.
We give you praise that your word shall perform, it shall produce, it shall not return unto you. Since 2004, they keep on hearing about the vision, keep on hearing about the vision, keep on hearing. But there is nothing produced. You understand?
Come on.
And people continue to perish because without vision, people perish. Nations are better. But this man came 1 year, last year, when he went back home, the fire that the guy. The man of God was expressing. He was running. No, not running. Himself. Flying.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes.
At the point that today, there is like a kind of evolution. Evolution.
Evolution.
Like a water that's boiling.
Yes.
Wherever he passed, it's through this man that the bishop. He told me for him to come and sit down 3 days to listen to messages. He said, that cannot be. But from the very first day, he made up his mind, this I will not miss.
Praise God.
You understand?
Yes.
The altar that he went, he said he's going to build in South Africa. He said it's a capacity of 25,000. And he said, you will come to dedicate it.
Mm.
And you will fly to me and the whole team to go and dedicate that.
Amen.
You see, there are people who respond to the word.
Come on.
Their hearts are burning at the word of God.
Mm.
You understand? So God give them the anointing and the grace to move with what they have heard. The Bible said, if you read Isaiah 62, the part that we read, Isaiah 66, I read that and I said, there are voices responding to the voice that they have heard. Some people hear the voice, but they are not responding.
Yes.
But those who are responding are those that will be able to profit.
Amen.
Yes.
Do you understand?
Yes.
And this mind, since the first. He not only is not giving God rest himself, he's not giving himself rest. He's just flying around with the word, with the vision. So we are blessed to have him today.
Amen.
And this year, we are sure we are going to his country.
Yes.
Many countries are inviting him right now.
Amen.
With that vision. Amen. His ministry can never be the same again.
Woo.
Because the anointing that he's carrying now is an anointing wherever you are, it will affect the place.
Amen.
Whatsoever country it is.
Praise God.
The nations, what the nation had for him that was kept and hindered because he was not after nations.
Mm-hmm.
Now that he's after the nations, nations are obligated to release the blessings of God that God has put in the nation for him.
Ooh.
It is technically U.S. U.S. has to release the blessings of U.S. that God has put in U.S. Now that he's praying for U.S., it has to come to him. He's stepping to South Africa. South Africa will release to him. He stepped to Kenya. Kenya will release. Bible says, we shall lend to many nations.
Wow.
You understand?
Yes.
As you are lending through your prayer, your travail, nations are obligated, they are activated to release the blessings of the nations into you.
Amen.
If you are releasing to yourself, it's just the blessing of the self that had to come to self.
Amen.
Do you understand? Oh, okay.
Hallelujah. Come on. Let's put our hands together for the general. What a grace. Come on, let's celebrate the Lord of God. What a grace, what an anointing we are seeking under. Come on, let's celebrate the Lord of God with your hands clapping. Thank you, Jesus. You may have your seat. Thank you, General. We count it as a privilege sitting under this great vision.
Amen.
Count it as a privilege.
Amen.
A blessing. At the same time, thank you very much for yourself and for our Esther and all the ministers of God under this house. May the Lord continue to increase you, to empower you, and to unveil that which has to be known for the nations to be empowered and imparted. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Come on, somebody say amen to that
one. Amen.
So, I may not have the anointing of Pastor Musa, which is heavy. You know, when a man stands for nations, you don't take him for granted. We are just in elementary school trying to learn from him. So, don't you mind if I am not able to preach as him, but at the same time, I just have a word of blessing for somebody.
Amen.
I didn't hear that person shout a big amen. I say, I may not preach today, but I have a word of blessing for you.
Amen.
And my pastor taught me that every time somebody say God bless you, you better shout a big amen.
Amen.
And I am here to say, may God bless you.
Amen.
I say it again, may God bless you.
Amen.
You say it amen like you mean it, may God bless you.
Amen.
Without wasting your time, turn your Bible with me in Isaiah chapter 41 and verse 20. Isaiah 41 and verse 20. We started on that one on Friday. As the Lord lives and leads, we will see what we can do today, and the rest we keep it for some other time.
Amen.
Isaiah chapter 41 and verse 20. Are you there?
Yes.
Are you there with your Bible?
Yes.
Can we read together? Let's go. 1, 2, go.
That they may see and know and consider.
Hold it. I think you went to school. So when we say read, let's read. Am I talking here?
Yes.
Oh, let's read. 1, 2, go.
That they may see and know and consider and understand together. That the hand of the Lord has done this, and the Holy One of Israel has created it.
That they may see, that they may know, that they may understand all of them together. That the hand of the Lord, not your boss, not your bank account, not your doctor, not even the American administration, but the hand of the Lord.
Yes.
I've done this thing.
Yes.
Let me announce to you under the sound of my voice. Everyone under the sound of my voice.
Yes.
Your bank account will soon know.
Yes.
That the hand of the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Did I say your bank account?
Amen.
Okay, let me say, very soon, yes, including your doctor,
yes,
will know it is not by might,
yes,
not by power, yes, not even by his consultation, by the hand of the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Very soon,
yes,
including your enemies,
yes,
will understand. They will see all together. Am I talking here?
Yes.
Including the ones that you left back home.
Yes.
They will all together come to understanding. Because they will see that what is taking place in your life, it is no longer because you went to some university. It is not even because you are beautiful. But it is because the hand of Jehovah, the same hand that created heaven and hell, the same hand that commanded the sea to depart, that is the same hand we are talking about. Before you finish this program, may the hand of God be upon you. I say, may it be upon you. And everyone will see. Not only your enemies, even your sympathizers.
Sympathizers.
Come on.
Including the ones that lost you.
Amen.
They will see it.
Amen.
Can you tell me three people around? They will see it.
They will see it.
Very soon they will see it. They used to know you boring. They used to know you boring. Oh my goodness. Look, they used to help you to come to church. Well, because they drive. But allow me to tell you, even the one giving you lift,
yes,
very soon,
yes,
I say very soon,
very soon,
he will see, he will understand,
he will consider,
and say, this cannot be anything but the hand
of the Lord. Amen.
I like to hear somebody here this morning.
Amen.
That they may see and know. God likes challenges.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. He likes challenges.
Yes.
Every time anything challenges you,
yes,
it empowers God,
yes,
and set him ready for answers.
Yes. Yes.
Come on.
Please.
Anything that challenges God in your life will be attained today in Jesus' name. Your faith, where is your God? We are an answer.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Come on.
That is the kind of God we like.
Amen.
I don't like the God of grammar that talks. I don't like that one. I want the God that answers by fire.
No compromise.
It's a tangible God.
Yes.
Yet invisible. Few questions and challenges were raised around his people, and he never kept quiet. He said, that they may know.
Yeah.
When God said that they may know, he really means that they will know. When God says that they may see, including the blind, we live on sin.
Amen, amen.
That is the kind of God we serve.
Amen.
Amen.
It's so serious and it means everything he says.
Yes, amen.
Today, may your finances come to know.
Amen.
That you have Jehovah Jireh.
Amen.
Today, your health, let it come to know.
Amen.
That you serve Jehovah Rapha.
Amen.
Everything around your life will be shaken in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, I started by telling you that there are few things that will help God to display and deploy his hand over your life.
Amen.
If ever you want to see the mighty hand of God moving in your life, there is this little, very little ingredient that you need. That is called faith. The Bible says, without faith, have all the diploma you want, but without faith, it is impossible. Let's stop there. It means when there is no faith, limitations are welcome. Where there is no faith, struggle will reside there.
Mercy.
The only thing that will help you to break through, to survive where others are being swallowed,
come on.
Hey.
Is called faith.
Hallelujah.
Faith. We take a foreigner, excuse me, in a foreign land and set him in the office of the prime minister without the paper.
Amen.
Yes.
Am I talking here?
Yes. Yes.
You doubt it, ask Daniel and Mr. Joseph in the Bible. That guy became prime minister. Papers were organized after he was already nominated and elected.
Hey.
Amen.
I suggest to you that faith is the major key, the key master that will open and unlock any desire of your heart.
Amen.
Without being supported by any human being.
Amen.
God will never answer by tears. God always answers to faith.
Hallelujah.
I'm not talking about faith. I'm talking about faith.
Yes.
Faith does not respect the color of skin. You can be yellow or green. Without faith, you will struggle.
Amen.
Yes.
Am I talking here?
Yes.
Amen.
Anyone that wants to see the hand of God need to operate by faith.
Yes.
And what is faith, by the way?
Come on.
Now faith is first of all the kind of faith that will make the hand of Jehovah Elohim upon your life is not the faith of yesterday.
Yes.
It is not the faith for tomorrow.
Yes.
It is the faith of now.
Now.
Yes.
No wonder the Bible says now faith is. It is tautology. When you already said now, why are you adding is?
It's the same.
Is it not the same thing?
It's the same.
Now and is it different?
No.
That is to emphasize that faith is now. Let me ask this question. When do you want your breakthrough?
Now.
When do you want your miracle?
Now.
When do you want your healing?
Now.
Come on, shout it now. Shout it like you mean it now. Trusting God just for tomorrow.
Yes.
The God that you are serving said, I am.
I am.
He never said, I was. He never said, I will be. He always said, I am. Listen to what I said. I am the I am that I am. I am the way. I am the truth.
Yes.
I am the good shepherd.
Yes.
I am the way.
Amen.
You want him now? He's there now for you.
Yes.
Am I talking here?
Yes.
The faith that will answer to your desire is the faith that you have now.
Amen.
Secondly, I already told you, I'm not Pastor Musa. So don't expect me to speak for 4 hours. You just invite me for a night vigil. Now, the Bible says, now faith is what?
The substance
of what?
Faith. Hope for.
I don't like substance. That one is too much grammar. I like it when they say evidence. And I more like it in French. They say demonstration. They say faith is demonstrating things you are hoping for. Is it no madness?
Yes.
Now I come to understand faith and madness are same papa, same mama.
Yes.
Come
on.
That's right.
Hey.
Yes.
Come on.
Which means and suggests to me that faith is madness.
Yes. Hey.
Yes.
Ah.
Yes. Yes.
Uh-huh.
You see, the reason why the hand of God is not moving upon your life, because you operate with your senses. Until you get out of your mind, until you learn to get out of your senses, then nothing will happen. Nobody will see the hand of God operating with his senses. Your senses are going to limit God.
Yes.
God operate with some mad folks.
Yes.
Am I talking to some mad people?
Yes.
Until you get mad in your spirit, until you step out of your senses, then you begin to operate in faith. You can't be normal and see the hand of God.
Yes.
The hand of God is for a normal human being.
Come on.
Can you imagine by the guy by the name of Peter? He had never seen a human being walk on water before. Am I right?
Right.
And here he sees Jesus walking. He said, this man is. He said, no, it's me. He said, okay, the way to believe that it is you, just bring me to come. Till I release the word, come. Some people say that Peter walked on water. I said, never read your Bible very well. Try to walk on water, you'll die. The next thing, you organize your funeral service.
You become sick.
You never walked on water. It's a lie. Faith cometh by hearing.
Yes, sir.
And what you hear is the word of God. And here Jesus said, come. Peter took that word, come. He took the word, come. And he threw it upon the waters. Then he stood upon the word. He started walking on the word that was upon the water.
Yes.
It starts by believing in your heart.
Yes.
Did he not tell you? If thou believest, thou shalt see the glory of God. It starts by believing in your heart. My general, so many people we hear the preacher like you traveling. Just say you're an entertainer. But some of us. When I hear, I believe in my heart. It's bubbling. I say, this is what I want.
Amen.
I'm going to fly with this one.
Yes.
The man doesn't know that he's talking to me. Yes. The man is infusing inside me some vitality and spiritual virus.
Yes.
That will never leave me the same again. Shakes your spirit and your mind. I'm not talking to you.
Yes.
Faith comes by hearing the very powerful word of God.
Amen.
And then you believe. That's grade number one.
Yes.
If you believe, it's good, but nothing will happen. No wonder so many people will come and attend the same service.
Yeah.
They hear the same word. Mm. They go and they never produce the same results.
Yes. Come on.
Yes.
As I'm talking here, you are hearing me.
Yes.
Yes.
You all are hearing the sound of my voice.
Yes.
But very few will produce what I call tangible results.
Mm.
Yeah. Yeah, God.
Because they stops at grade one.
Come on.
Grade two.
First grade, second grade.
It starts by hearing in your heart and speaking with your mouth. You say what you believe.
Amen.
Don't say what other people suggest to you. Don't say what you're feeling like. Don't say what your bank account suggests to you. Don't even talk about the history of your family, how poor you were. I don't care. If I believe beyond the poverty of my family, I would rather boldly say that God, let the poor say, don't keep quiet. Let the poor say, I'm not talking here. Let the poor say, don't keep quiet. Don't complain, don't complain. Don't give excuses. Open your mouth and boldly say, whether they will hear and like it, whether they will support you or fight you, I don't care. Let the
ball
stay.
You say what you believe.
Yes.
Yes.
You say what you believe.
Yes.
Don't say what others suggest to you.
Stop.
Can I go do?
Yes.
Don't even be intimidated by other people's achievement.
Yeah.
Yes. Say what you believe.
Amen.
Because there are achievements around you that can silence you. You look around and say, hey, this is a human being. Should I open my mouth? I will open my mouth.
Hey.
And I will let everyone know that before I die, a French white guy from, oh my goodness, he will be driving me and some Chinese will be at my restaurant.
Hey.
Yes.
Hey.
Before I die, that is a decree. It is written. Not a decree.
Established.
I didn't ask that you will support me by paying them. I'm just telling you what I am expecting.
Amen.
So you better learn to talk. That was great.
Two.
God great.
Now, for you not to become a liar. After you have made some powerful and dangerous statements publicly, you know sometimes they call you back, but you say, you know what you say? Now for you not to become a liar, after you have believed, after you have spoken, grade 2, 3. That is what I call Champions League.
Champions League.
Champions League.
That is first class.
First class.
Have you traveled before?
Yes.
Could some of you just hang around America? You are local. Even while being in America, you are local. Some of you are local. Don't think because you're American, you're international, you are local. You don't know anything, you are local.
It's true.
Am I joking?
Yes, it's true.
Grade number 3.
Yes.
You have now to prove that which you believed and you spoke by demonstrating your proofs. The apostle says, faith without works is what?
Dead.
That is what I call fake.
Right.
If you only believe and speak, you do not prove or demonstrate or show evidences, it is fake.
It's fake.
That is why I suggested to you that faith and madness works together. How are you going to demonstrate things that you have not in your hand? Is it no madness?
Yes.
How? And I didn't see it. So why? How am I going to demonstrate? Yes, that's how faith operates. To walk with God, it takes madness. You know, a mad, have you seen a madman feeding on a trash before?
Yes.
What is your reaction? Am I right?
Yeah.
And he goes there taking some decay, funny stuff, you know, smelling like hair. And he goes enjoying it. And he says, what is this? Yes. Because you are not out of your senses. That is why he is shocking you. But according to him, he's out of his senses. According to him, that's Italian restaurant.
Amen.
Come on.
For that mad fellow is enjoying Italian food. He sees what you do not see. He enjoys, therefore, what you cannot enjoy.
Right.
And that is exactly the same thing in the spirit. Until you are acting like a mad fool, fellow, in the spirit, enjoying what others cannot enjoy, eating what others cannot eat, you will never see the hand of God. This is exactly how it is. Now let me bring it down to where you are, because you seem to look at me funny. After you have heard and received a powerful word of prophecy, is there anybody waiting for me to take me somewhere? Is the person around? Okay, this is the last one, sir. But when I come back, I will stay here. I will go nowhere when I come back, sir. Listen to me. Listen to me. Listen to me. This is how it works. I've received the word. I've heard it. Right? I've publicly confessed it with excitement. After the church is over, that is your test.
Yes.
The test is not here because
everybody
is making us excited.
Yes.
Madness is not here. We allow you that here. But we are waiting for you out there.
Yes.
That is where you will go and face your real challenges one-on-one. Real stuff awaiting you there to give answers.
Yes.
That is where your madness is expected.
Yes.
Not here.
Yes.
Not here.
Yes.
When you look at yourself in the mirror, you were 25, nobody proposed to you. Now you're 48, nobody seen coming. That is where now you got to get mad. Am I talking here?
Yes.
That is where you get to get mad. Madness will make you do things that people will look at you and say, but you're going crazy. You don't even have money to go and feed yourself. But here you go and hey, how much is this car?
Come on.
Am I talking to some folks here? Just this morning, then I ran up until the next time. No, don't worry, I'm still in America for a few times. I hope my general will give me some more time. Let me give this testimony to tell you how madness works. I had to move to a new place. I told my wife, before we go, we make sure that everything that is here is whole. It's not going to us with us in a new place. In a new place, the only old things which are allowed to be carried there are us, you and me. Everything to be taken, they should be new. And my wife knew the degree of my madness. She submit to my madness. So I'm blessed to have a fellow that understands my folly. And I started giving out everything in my house. I gave out everything in my living room, in my bedroom, in my kitchen. I gave out everything. Now we were 2 days to move to the new place.
That's right.
Everything. And there are nothing.
Demonstration.
There are nothing. We are 2 days to go to the new place, and I've given out everything. Oh my God.
Demonstration.
I took my wife on Friday. I said, okay, let's go and see the kind of furniture you want us to have in our house. Friday. We have to move there by 2 months. And we went. It was around 3 p.m. I was, come on, go ahead and choose. She was very confident that this guy is carrying some. He's a pastor, a man of God, by that time. And I gave her time. She was moving around, choose this one, finally, she came to a point that she has selected everything she wanted. Now, I was now to pay. I said, okay, you know, darling, you know, by this time, I think it's getting quite late. Then we start taking these things and take it there. You know, we'll not be able to finish on time. And you know, we have to go to church. Darling, don't worry, tomorrow, Saturday morning, I myself will come here and pick everything you have selected, then you will find it in the next place. She trusted me, she gave me the keys. And I called the one that was selling. I said, come, when do you open the sale? I said, it's 9. Okay, do you have any phone number? I'm talking to people while I have no pen in my pocket.
Amen.
I'm serious. My wife will be here. She will testify. By the way, I know why I'm giving this testimony. And finally, she trusted me, we left. We went back home after prayer. The next day, it was Saturday morning, we went to prayer. We had our prayer meeting. We started around 6 in the morning. By 8, the meeting was over. Before I know it, my wife knows to that point that it is that very morning that I will be going to. She was very confident. Very confident. And you know what? I couldn't reduce it down because I've already spoken and I've already demonstrated. There is no way I will tell my wife that, you know, it was by faith. No. I said that thing must work.
Amen.
And it is 8 a.m. in the morning. You see this lady. Please, will you stop? Let me testify. I've never said it wherever she had been before. You see this very lady. After the service, she ran to me. Daddy, my husband, you can see, my husband wants to see you. I said, hey, what is the problem of shaking? If she wants to see me, let him come. What is the problem? And here comes the man, a gentleman. Sir, by the way, me and my wife, we heard that you're moving into a new place, and it was shaking. I said, man, you're a man now, open your mouth and talk to me. What is wrong with you? Therefore, I said, go ahead, you're wasting my time, man. My wife is still waiting for me.
Amen.
She's here. This is not grammar. She's here. If I will lie to you, I can't lie to her. She's here. And then the husband said, we made it a point that as you're moving to a new place, everything in your living room, we are going to. I said, we are going to what? We are buying that. I said, I told my wife, and she said, my wife, the lady, will be going with my wife. Mm-hmm. I said, all right. Then I called my wife, I told you. You remember, I said that today. Huh? I said, yes. Now, I don't have time. You know, I'm a busy person. Yeah! Therefore, I suggest to you a lady that will take you to where you know. And I called the lady, I said, you are going with my dad. They made it a point that we go on Monday because, you know, it was raining on Monday. My wife went with my daughter. You know where we went to look at the furniture? It was a local one. The one that our own carpenters in Jesus. But the one that they are using, they are heavy people. The one that they use is the one that comes from abroad. It is machine. And mechanically made, not a human being. So when you see it, you say hallelujah, and it answers Hosanna. So I went from ordinary to extraordinary. They went to the place, my wife was shaking because the best price she saw. even your grandma, or even your grandma. She was like shivering. And the man said, no, don't worry, mom. I will choose for you. Got this one. At the end, it was about $12,000.
Yes.
Because they know them, they brought they reduced some other. She brought out money, cash, right there. Pian, pian, pian. Right there. And they took it. Meanwhile, I'm hanging around somewhere. I don't even know what is happening. Took it to the place a day before we move in the house. And I said, I'm going to say, I enter the place. When I open it, Master, Toyota, Mitsubishi, Suzuki, Mercedes, oh my God. I never had it, I believed it, I spoke it, I demonstrated, if you are broke, you can demonstrate your prosperity. Am I talking to somebody? Yeah. Lift up your hands, lift up your voice, begin to praise Him. Begin to praise Him. Listen. You have 2 minutes to get out from here. How many of you want this kind of anointing? So come quickly and put the word. See your soul. Your seed. See your soul. Show your seed quickly. Because you have 2 minutes. Show your seed. Get that anointing. Throw back every seed that you sow. Let the Spirit of God release that anointing.
Thank you. there is a pledge concerning the headquarters of the Washington.